Hello dear student, now we are going to start a new chapter. The name of the chapter is chapter 6, problems on simultaneous linear equation. Or in short, we know very well, we are saying that it is a word problem. Means the question is given in the form of a statement or language statement. First, you need to convert a statement problem into the mathematical expression. After conversion of mathematical expression, you can simplify as usual as from the previous chapter 5, simultaneous linear equation. So the first thing is to convert expression into the mathematical expression. Mostly two statement is given, so convert in a two linear equation, and after that you can simplify any one of the method, like eliminating method or substitution method or cross multiplication method. It is your choice. Choose any one of the method and then simplify the question. Now I am going to solve a few questions. After that you will try in the next 2 days. You can try question number 1, exercise 6, question number 1 to first 15 questions. Now I discuss a few of the question between 1 to 15, then you will understand easily and then solve the rest of the question. Now question number 1, the statement of the question is, the sum of two numbers is 50 and their difference is 16. Find the numbers. Let the number, now you are going to suppose the number, let the number be x and y, because he told the number is two numbers. So we are going to discuss you number be x and y. The very first statement is, the sum of the two numbers is 50. Sum of the two number is equals to 50. It is the first expression convert into a mathematical expression. So x plus y equals to 50, very first, and their difference means the second statement is, and their difference x minus y, that is equal to 16, equation number 2. After that you can simplify, you can simplify and find out the value of x and y. My role is to make the expression into a mathematical expression, and after that you know very well how to solve this linear equations simultaneously. So apply any one of the method, it is your choice, eliminating, substitution or cross multiplication. So I make the equation and then always write down, do it yourself. In simplification, if you have faced any problem, you can ask in a problems day, right? So choose another one. I choose a question number, random choose the question number 4. Question number 4, the cost of 5 kilogram of sugar and 7 kilogram of rice is rupees 153, and the cost of 7 kilogram of sugar and 5 kilogram of rice is rupees 147. Find the cost of 6 kilogram of sugar and 10 kilogram of rice. So first you need to suppose the cost of 1 kilogram of sugar is, we suppose x rupees, and the cost of 1 kilogram of rice we suppose rupees y. So let the cost of first one is sugar is rupees x per kg, let the cost of rice is rupees y per kg. Now the 5 kg of sugar means 5x, and the 7 kilogram of rice plus 7y is always equals to given 153. And the cost of 7 kilogram of sugar, you can say 7x, and the 5 kilogram of rice, you can say 5y, is equals to 147. Again, we have made the two equation, so solve simultaneously. It is your work, do it yourself. Find the value of x and y. Now come to question number I choose the another one, question number 6. If from twice the greater of two numbers 16 is subtracted, the result is half the other number. If from half the greater number one is subtracted, the result is still half the other number. What are the numbers? Okay, let the two numbers be x and y. Now statement number 1, you can also write this statement 1. If from twice the greater of the two number, suppose greater number is this, twice the greater of the two number 16 is subtracted. If from twice the greater of the two number 16 is subtracted, the result is half the other number y by 2. Suppose the greater number is x, smaller number is y. What he say, this according to the question, that twice the greater of the number and then 16 subtracted, that is equal to the half of the second number. Now you can cross multiply by this, 4x minus 32 is equals to y, or you can say 4x minus y is equals to 32. Equation number 1. For statement 2, again, if from half the greater number, ye lijiye, half of the greater number, one is subtracted, the result is still half the other number. Again, the statement is like this. So, what do you think? The important simplify the statement first to multiply it by 2 in the whole equation. So, x minus 2 is equals to y, or you can say x equals to y plus 2, equation number 2. I just convert into a substitution method, question convert into substitution method. You can put x, y plus 2 in equation first and find y, and after that finding the value of y, you can put any one of the equation and then get x. So it is a question number, you can see that the question number is 6. Now come to the another one. Question number basically based question number 10 basically based on the fraction numerator and the denominator. Now first think about what is a fraction. Fraction means numerator and the denominator. Every fraction having a two part, numerator part and the denominator part. You know very well, in short we are saying NR and DR. So fraction is NR by DR, and the separate part is numerator and the denominator. So suppose fraction be x by y, where x is a numerator and y is a denominator. Okay, you can say numerator, in numerator is x and denominator is y. So the question is, if one is added to the numerator, if statement 1, case 1 or statement 1, if 1 is added to the numerator means x plus 1 of a fraction, it becomes 1 by 5, x plus 1 by y. Only add 1 in the numerator and the fraction is x plus 1 by y, that is equals to becomes 1 by 5. Now cross multiplication, 5x plus 5 is equals to y. So 5x minus y is equals to minus 5, equation number 1. Case second, if 1 is taken from the denominator, 1 is taken from the denominator, okay, numerator as it is, 1 minus y minus 1, it becomes 1 by 7, becomes 1 by 7. Cross multiplication again, 7x is equals to y minus 1, so 7x minus y is equals to minus 1, equation number 2. Now you make the two equation, equation 1 and equation 2, and then you can solve simultaneously and find the value of x and y, but your answer should be in the form of x upon y, because in the question he asked find the fraction. So the fraction means x by y. Don't leave the answer in x separate like 2, y separate like minus 3. It is an example, I give just example. Don't leave the question at this position, because he asked you find the fraction. Fraction means x by y, that means 2 by minus 3, right dear? So you can try, I think easily you can solve the question till question number 15. So in the next 2 days, first try question number 1 to 15, and then ask the problem on Monday. I take the problem on Monday from 1 to 15, and after that we will start from 16 to the last of 32. Thank you very much. Take care.